Armstrong moved here in 1943, and he was here the last 20 years of his life. He actually died in his home in 1971. My name's Ricky Riccardi. I'm the Director of Research Collections for the Louis Armstrong House Museum, sometimes known as Wikipedia for my Armstrong obsessions, but really and truly, I am all Armstrong all the time. We have about 750 reel-to-reel tapes that Louis made in the last 20 years of his life, and a lot of those tapes were made in this room. He would record himself practicing. He would dub his LPs to tape. Sometimes he would act as a disc jockey and address an imaginary audience.
That's my story, folks. I guess I'm stuck with it. I usually say nice things also about human beings if they deserve it. I never want to be any more than I am. And what I don't have, I don't need it anywho. I've always loved and I always lived a normal life, which I appreciate very much. And I've always loved everybody, still do.
We even have one tape where he gets into a pretty vicious argument with his wife, Lucille, and she doesn't know he's tape recording it.
Well, go to bed, I'll be there. Right behind you. And turn your television, your finger majigger. Now what the shit, you got that fucking thing on? Hey.
Honey, well, you gone.
Turn your red tape recorder on. I'll be flopping me off.
I got thousands of tapes.
I wouldn't give a shit about your thousands of tapes. You can come with them tomorrow. Turn your tape off. In fact, erase out some of that shit.
You're getting nervous, man.
I ain't getting nervous, but you ain't, you know, you ain't got no better
That's
sense.
That's posterity.
Posterity my ass. You got no better sense than play that for some of your, not even friends. Somebody that come in here that you don't even know.
To me, that for posterity, that's the whole reason we have a house museum, the whole reason we have the research collections at Queens College. Armstrong, as unassuming and humble and down home as he was, knew what he had to endure, knew what he conquered, poverty, racism, you name it, to break down these barriers, to change the sound of music, and he wanted to be in control of his own story.
So we were born, all you part of me still, oh yes, for you were my thrill, yes. On Blueberry Hill, yeah, man.
There wouldn't be a Louis Armstrong House Museum without Lucille Armstrong. She was the fourth Mrs. Armstrong. She was in show business. She was a cotton club dancer. Actually, the first dark-skinned dancer hired by the Cotton Club, the usually only hired light-skinned African-American woman. Lucille married Louis in October 1942. In March 1943, she found out that there was this home for sale, 3456 107th Street in Corona. She moved in, she put the down payment down, she moved her mother in, got the house all situated. Louis was on tour for about 6 more months, and she never told him. It's not a very lavish home, but it was more than Armstrong ever had since he was raised in such poverty in New Orleans, and he ended up living here for the next 28 years of his life.
Ever since we married, we've been right there in that block, and everybody keeps their little homes up like we do, and it's just like one big family, and they're all with their children, grandchildren. They come back to see Uncle Sesmo and Aunt Lucille.